Colonel Vindman testified that he thought it was very accurate. Did you as well?
I viewed it as complete and accurate.
Okay. Colonel Vindman did articulate that he had a couple edits. He wanted Burisma inserted. I think it was on page 3 or 4 in place of the company in one of the sections where President Zelensky was talking. Are you aware of that edit request?
I understand that he said in either this proceeding or the deposition that he wanted that request, yes.
Okay. At the time, did you understand that he had asked for that?
I don't recall that. It was my practice, if I believed an edit accurately represented the call, I would accept it. If I didn't hear it in the call, if it didn't exist in my notes, I wouldn't have made the edit.
Okay. Yeah, he just on page 4, he wanted to swap out the word company for Burisma. And when that edit from Colonel Vindman was not installed, did he give you any negative feedback that it was crucial that that edit get in the document?
Not that I can recall.
Okay. Did he ever raise any concerns to you about the accuracy of the transcript?
Not that I can recall.
Did he ever raise any concerns to you generally about the call?
When we were discussing track changes version of the MemCon, I believe he had some concerns about the call. I believe we both agreed we wanted that more full-throated embrace of President Zelensky and his reform agenda, and we didn't get it.
Okay. You indicated in your deposition that when you took over the portfolio for Dr. Hill, July 15th, you were alerted to potential issues in Colonel Vindman's judgment?
Yes.
Did she relay anything specifically to you? Why she thought that?
Not as such. It was more of a overarching statement from her and her deputy, who became my deputy, that they had concerns about judgment.
Okay. Did any other NSC personnel raise concerns with you about Mr. Vindman?
Yes.
Colonel Vindman. And what were some of those concerns that were brought to your attention?
There were...
I'm sorry, we are not going to... I'm going to instruct him not to answer. I'm going to instruct him not to answer because I think that it's beyond the scope of what you're asking for. These concerns, Mr. Castor, predated any involvement with Ukrainian sector assistance.
Well, during the deposition, I asked you, Mr. Morrison, whether others raised the concern that Colonel Vindman may have leaked information.
You did ask that, yes.
Yeah, and your answer was?
Others had represented that, yes.
Okay. And I asked you whether you were concerned Colonel Vindman did not keep you in the loop at all times with his official duties?
Yes.
And in fact, when he went to the National Security Council lawyers following the July 25th call, he did not first come to you, is that correct?
Correct.
And you were his supervisor in the chain of command, correct?
Correct.
And in hindsight, did you wish that he had come to you first before going to the lawyers?
Yes.
And why is that?
One, if he had concerns about something, about the content of the call, that's something I would have expected to have been notified of. I also think, just as a matter of practice, since we both went to the lawyers, we didn't necessarily both need to, and economy of effort may have prevailed.
Okay. At any point subsequently, did he become frustrated that he felt cut out of some of the Ukraine portfolio?
Yes.
And what was the nature of his concerns?
Well, I think the easiest way to say it is he was concerned with respect to, for example, the Ukraine trip that he was not, he did not go. He asked me why it was my practice to have a number of the conversations with Ambassador Taylor one-on-one. And there were certain other matters.
Okay. And did you ever get the sense that you resolved his concerns or did they linger?
I explained to him my thinking, and That was that.